Hair transplant scar advice, desperately needed, please. Hi, stupidly 2 years ago, I got a hair transplant which left me with a scar, ear to ear, and live with it every day, either by wearing hats or bandanas, as the hair did not grow. Moving on, I have thought about getting micro hair tattooing over the scar, but I need to get rid of the pinky brown areas around the scar, and was wondering if there was anything anyone suggested to clear. Soften this, please. Picture attached. I've seen reports on a new treatment called RECELL, but some say a chemical peel, perhaps. There are so many things, not knowing who to trust no more. It would be good if someone could shed some light, please. Thank you. Riz.
Thank you for your question. In your question, you wrote that 2 years ago you went for a hair transplant. Clearly, you're very unhappy about the scar that resulted, and you've submitted a photo of that scar. It's a linear scar consistent with a strip method for hair transplant. And you also mentioned some options as to how to make the scar better. So this is not an unusual issue, and I think it's very often the result of really about communication. You see, hair transplantation, whether it's the strip method or the follicular unit extraction method, still results in scars. And part of our consultation is an explanation and understanding of these scars. I'm not only a hair transplant surgeon, I'm also a full body cosmetic surgeon. So discussions about scars is something I do all day long, whether it's for tummy tucks, whether it's for facelifts, whether it's for breast surgery. So in our discussion about a hair transplant scar, I explain to our patients that we use not only cosmetic surgical techniques to make these incisions close as well as possible, but we also use a material called extracellular matrix and platelet-rich plasma, which we use in a treatment called hair regeneration to further enhance the healing. Now, that being said, wound healing is a process that happens over the course of 6 months to a year. And even with the best closure, with the most advanced technology in terms of biomaterials, you can still get a scar that's undesirable. A scar that's undesirable can be a widened scar, it can be a thickened scar, it can be an irregular scar, but it is part of the understanding that when we tell our patients is, you know, prepare for understanding that if you were not to have the best healing, yes, we could potentially revise the scar, but it's really about how the body heals. And that is that's something that we can't always predict. So you've mentioned some options in terms of tattooing or a new technology that's being used for wound healing for burns. The reality is that the scar is at the deeper level, and what's responsible for the thickening is more about the type of scars that sometimes people refer to as a hypertrophic or keloid scar. In our practice, if someone has a thickened scar like yours, we employ injections of materials such as 5-fluorouracil or 5-FU and Kenalog, as well as we've had some very nice results with injections with platelet-rich plasma. Now, platelet-rich plasma has been very, very successful in our practice for areas of hypertrophic scars or thickened scars to soften them and ideally allowing some more hair growth to occur through those scars. So I think that you, now that you've had your transplant, you are somewhat committed to having your hair length a little bit longer to make sure the scar is covered. And if you are aware of the scar being obvious when your hair is wet or if someone is noticing it, then you may want to consider either a surgical scar revision or the treatment with injections. But I don't think a topical application of any treatment will do that much. I would caution you also about medical tattooing. Although it can look good in pictures, three-dimensionally, it may not look right for you. So I think you need to do some consultations with some cosmetic surgeons who have a lot of experience with scars and understanding what your options are. And you know, you can't erase a scar. You can make a bad scar into a better scar, but you can't eliminate it altogether. So I would be cautious about what you pursue. So I wish you the best of luck. I hope that was helpful, and thank you for your question.